Welcome back to the live DG Sax, Derrick Griffin with me. I'm Peter Hostrasser, disrupteducation.co. What's up, man? You've had a good weekend, man.
Great weekend, man. You know, love is in the air, as we know, this month. We just passed Valentine's Day and, man, had a couple weddings, you know. Shout out to the River Roast right off of LaSalle, right across from the River Rock. Great venue for those who are looking to get married soon or just looking for some private dining in the city. You also got the Langham Hotel in Chicago. Want to give a shout out to Rosanna Weddings. Her team is incredible. She's an event planner in the Chicago area. Got an opportunity to work with her on New Year's Eve. She posted a video of me, and just off of the strength of that video, I had got someone who reached out to me saying, hey, listen, we've been looking for a saxophone player, and it worked out great. The crowd was amazing. Just great energy. You know, got a chance to work with a new DJ. Shout out to DJ Lee Michaels. He works with the Blackhawks. He works with the Chicago Cubs, and is doing some really great stuff coming up this summer, too. He's got some fundraising events he's working with, so we're looking to collaborate in the near future.
Yeah. So yeah. Follow DG Sax at DG Sax or DG Sax underscore. Because you'll see anybody who's out there listening to this, you'll see these awesome videos. It's really cool to see. And you know, what I started doing is paying attention to the music, like the actual, you know, what's the song and everything. And you can see, you know, you have different moods, different things are happening, all those different things. So my question today is what would your playlist look like? What would, like, if I'm cruising and I'm listening to a streaming service, number one, what's your streaming service? And number two, what's your playlist look like?
Man, so it's crazy. I actually use two different streaming. Well, actually three, now that I think about it. and there's a reason for all of them, I promise. So SiriusXM number one was the reason why I started playing the saxophone. My dad used to always listen to Watercolors driving on the road, you know, delivering packages, and Watercolors always had music with no lyrics. So all I ever heard was the instruments, saxophone, trumpet, guitar, drums, you name it. And the saxophone was the one instrument that always stuck out to me. So that's why I use SiriusXM, especially after my gigs. I don't want to listen to any songs that have lyrics. So you may catch me on Watercolors or listen to something like Kenny G, something very low key. Mm-hmm. And then when it comes to Spotify, I think Spotify does a really excellent job of, like, you being able to learn about new artists that maybe you've never heard of, right? And that's how I've discovered a lot of new music. And then when it comes to Apple Music, I do like the quality of sound that you receive. And believe it or not, I really can tell, like, from a volume standpoint, like, hearing the bass, and just like if I have headphones on, the way they transition the sound from the left ear to the right ear. So there's certain things sonically that I like about all streaming platforms. So if anybody's ever wondering, well, why do you pay this price for this streaming platform? There's a reason why, and really just the quality of sound that you're going to receive. But if I had to choose, let's say, two to three artists, number one would be Michael Jackson on my list, the king of pop in my eyes. I love Prince. I love, you know, those that came even before him, James Brown, you name it. But I think Michael Jackson, just from his ability to start as a kid until now, like, I mean, it was incredible. I mean, had I been able to see him live, I mean, that would have been like a dream come true. He's my idol. I've got videos of me dancing to Michael Jackson growing up, and all I ever heard was Dancing Machine and Thriller. And then looking at all those videos, I mean, just the cinematics and everything behind it, I think is kind of in light of how I play too. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm not the type to just, like, sit in front of a mic stand and just kind of stay stationary. I like to move around. I like to engage with the crowd, and then seeing how different age groups interact, because I think a lot of times they see me, you know, I'm a younger cat out there playing. They're like, this guy's playing Earth, Wind, and Fire. He's playing, you know, some, you know, all different artists that are way before his generation. But I like to get those reactions. You know, I play a Bill Withers, I play an Al Green or something like that, right? But then when we zoom up to today, I mean, I think about someone like J. Cole, who I'm very influenced by, just lyrically, the things that he talks about in his songs, but then, like, just some of the instrumentation, even Kendrick Lamar being another one that I really like. I remember seeing him live back in 2017. So you may catch me listening to some J. Cole or maybe some Kendrick or something that's upbeat before like a performance. I almost put the mind frame of like me going to a basketball game in high school, you know, getting prepped on the bus, got my headphones on. Mm-hmm. I'm getting ready. I'm getting geared up for the game. It's game time. Like I'm getting ready for the gig, you know, and just getting in my zone. And then as soon as I get there, I'm setting up all my equipment. I've got everything going. I got the speakers going. I got, you know, my soundtrack coming out and making sure everything's balanced. Cause I think that's really half of the battle. You know, you want to have quality sound. And that's when you're going to be able to deliver the best of the best artists, you know, no matter what music you're playing. So
it's pretty amazing how many like people like in the industry, like talk Michael Jackson. I mean, still today, right? That's pretty, that's incredible. All right, man, here's a test. You got your phone on you?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's put it up to the screen, man. Pull one of those up, and let's see what song you got, man. Let's see what song just shows up. I want to see. Okay. I think our live viewers, man, we're doing a little interaction here.
Okay. Well, hey, we got
no cheating, man. Just pull it up.
Some PYT. Yeah,
see,
no?
Man. See, it's fuzzy because you got your background fuzzy.
I got the little background. Yeah, PYT, man. Way to go.
You know what's interesting is I have video of both my son and daughter as like. And they were, you know, like seven I would be 7 and 4 dancing to Michael Jackson. I think almost every parent out there does. Man. That's kind of funny. So speaking of that, you know, moving and all right, dude. And I know we've talked a little bit about this before and you get out there on the dance floor. Are you taking something from James Brown? Are you taking something from Michael Jackson? How do you know?
I'm gonna go Bruno Mars actually. I feel Mars is like the modern day like Michael Jackson. Obviously not as great as Mike, like he's great in his own right. But I think what's so cool about Bruno, I've watched him live and he's got a whole band that does the same choreography as him. Like they're in coordination, like dancing, singing at the same time, and they sound good. Like, you know, sometimes you try to do one or the other and it's a give or take. Either you're good at the singing, the dancing's not as good, or vice versa, but both are like elite, you know, very elite. And it's super impressive to see that. And I think that's what's helped me to even just learn like how to build stamina, you know, throughout a performance. A lot of times people watch me, they're like, dude, you've been going for an hour and a half. Like, like you've probably got lungs of, you know, of Usain Bolt or someone that does, you know, track athletes and running and stuff. And I was just like, you know, over time, building that up, you know, just through experience, I think is what's helped me a lot. But yeah, Bruno Mars for sure, man. Yeah. I mean, for those who've never seen Bruno Mars, I definitely recommend like checking him out. Yeah. It's amazing. Yeah.
Totally. Why? Like, it reminds me of his SNL when he was on live there. And I remember that.
Oh, yeah.
It was so different because he was like moving around and, you know, they had some props and stuff. It was pretty, pretty cool.
Super inspiring.
Yeah. Great, great stuff. So, you out of weekends, what's it look like, man? If I want to book a wedding, what am I looking? You got a few spots, have them check in.
Hey man, you know, I know St. Patrick's Day is coming up, but the calendar is looking a little bit open for March, which is good. So if you have an event coming up, you know, reach out to me. We can definitely connect. For those who don't know, Daniel Bevan, he's my manager on the back end. He helps me with all my bookings. And he's, you know, currently helping me out with April as well. We've got a event we're doing with the Ronald McDonald organization, a charity event coming up on the 27th with Off the Cuff and the DJ Firm. And then I will be having a public event for those who don't know. Tin Roof Chicago in Wrigleyville. It's a public event. A lot of these events I do are usually private. So I really want to try to, you know, continue to share more of my public events with those who are out there that are looking for some live entertainment in the city. If you're in the Chicagoland area, it's a good time. It's going to be right after the Cubs game. I know you're not a huge Cubs fan, but it's going to be right after opening day. right after the first opening day. It's going to be the first Saturday, April 6th. So 6 o'clock. The 305 game. If you got nothing to do, come on by and listen to some good tunes. It's gonna be a good time.
Great. DGSax.com. I'm Peter Hostrasser, disrupteducation.co. Hey man, let's keep it going. We're gonna dance right out of here.
Let's keep it high. PYT.